Hello everyone, this is Ashwini from Our Journey of Happiness and Woody Goodies team. So this video is all about these colorful cubes, rainbow cubes that we have recently launched in our group Woody Goodies. So many moms who have purchased from this group have asked me what kind of games can be done using these cubes. A lot of games, if planned, can be done to keep our toddlers busy. These cubes are actually excellent for free play, but along with the free play, if planned properly, many simple DIY games can be created at home only. So in this video, I shall be showing you what kind of games can be done at home. So firstly, color sorting. This I have already done with my toddler. I have already posted the video in the group. Basically, for this, what we can do is we can just have a sensory bin consisting of all the cubes, all colored cubes, and then we can just ask the toddler to just search for the color and sort it according to the color. So blue color goes into the blue basket, red one goes into the red basket, and the yellow one goes into the yellow basket. So likewise, you can introduce color sorting in this way. Sensory bins are excellent for toddlers. It builds interest in the toddlers. They explore the sensory bin, and along with that, sorting is done in a very interesting manner. So at the beginning stage, you can just start with two colors. It depends on your toddler. But here I had done almost 4 to 5 baskets because Adar was very familiar with the baskets. So this one is the first basket, first activity. And then the second activity is number introduction. So this I have created at home. I haven't introduced numbers to Adar yet, but if you have already introduced or planning to introduce, I think in this we can use these cubes in a very creative way. This is nothing but a DIY mat which I have done. Here there are only till 6 digits. So here what the child can do is just place the cubes according to the number. So number 1, so one cube goes here, and again 2, so the child can place 2 cubes over here. Again 3, so the child can place 3 cubes. Likewise, the child can finish this mat. In this way, numbers can be introduced to the toddler in a very interesting manner. This is the second activity. And the third simple one is these, again, number cards. This is again a DIY cards. I basically don't have flashcards right now, number flashcards. So this is the one which I have introduced, which I have done at home. So 1, 2, 3. Likewise 4. So again, according to the number card, the child can place the number. So 1, so 1 cube. Again 2, so 2 cubes. 3 cubes. So like this, the child can put the quantity according to the symbol, numeric symbol. You can place it in the ascending order, or you can place it randomly. If your child is well versed with numbers already, so you can place it randomly, and you can ask the child to place the cubes according to the cards. So that will become a little difficult level for the kids. So again, it will be an interesting way to teach them numericals. So this is the next activity. Next activity is this ice tray activity. Here we have printed few patterns, and all here the child has to do is copy and reproduce the pattern here. So yellow color, again red color, green. So basically the child has to copy and reproduce the same pattern into the ice tray. Ice tray is just to make interesting for the toddler. You can also do it on a blank or a square sheet. If you have ice tray, then it is very interesting for them. So this is copy and paste pattern, ice tray activity. So for the ice tray activity, I have created a few DIY patterns. So the child has to do so many patterns. If not, you can just draw it on a paper, or you can just arrange it first there, and then the child can copy it onto the ice tray. The next activity is spatial intelligence activity. So here I have done a DIY plain mat, and here I have done a pattern. All the child has to do is just copy the pattern. This is spatial intelligence. So here it has to reproduce the same pattern. So orange goes here, green goes here, very excellent activity regarding the spatial intelligence. So this is the way the child has to reproduce. This again I have DIY at home. You can just create the same at home. This is the spatial intelligence activity, which can be done using the cubes. Again, using the same mat, we can do another activity. Something like this. I have written numbers on that pattern card. The child has to put the same number of cubes and copy onto this mat. Something like there is one here, so the child has to place one cube over here, and then here there is two cubes, so the child has to put two cubes, again one cube here, it says 1 2 3 3 cubes, three cubes. So likewise the child has to reproduce the same quantity over here onto the mat. This is the next activity. One more activity which we can do easily using these cubes is like just create a pattern, square pattern, and write random colors on them. Something like this. I've just put this pattern and I've labeled few colors on it. So what the child has to do is just put the color cube onto the square, something like orange. So orange, yellow, red, so red, blue, green, so green, blue, red. So once we fill in that, we will get a structure. So interesting way to see if the toddler can read the words and recognize the color. This is just a DIY idea activity that I just planned it. So this can be done. Okay, so the next activity which I have planned is these coordinates activity. This is the DIY sheet which I have done at home. So this activity is like the child has to put the same colored cubes onto the mat coordinates. So the first one red and orange. So the child has to place two cubes, that is one is red and the second one is orange. So next is red and yellow. So again the child has to put one red and one yellow cube. Likewise the child has to complete the entire mat coordinates activity. Okay, so the next activity is 3D structure activity. So for this again we can do a DIY 3D structures at home itself. If not, there are lot of printables, free printables available on different sites, so one can download from them. So this is a simple one which I have done. I will show you right now this one. The child has to do a 3D structure of the same. The 3D structure activity which can be done using these cubes. Okay. The next activity is memory game. Again for this what the child has to do is like we will place an empty mat here and we will show one design to the child. So the child will observe the design for few minutes or few seconds depending on the age of your child, and then we shall ask the child to see the design and reproduce the same. So we will close the sheet and we will ask the child to reproduce the same. So the child will reproduce whatever the design. So this is an excellent memory activity. I hope this is correct. Okay, so memory game which works excellent for toddlers or kids. Likewise you can have as many designs as you can. Start with a simple structure and then you can create a complex one. So this is one thing which we can do, memory game. The next activity is pattern activity. So using the cubes we can have AB patterns, AAB patterns, ABC patterns, something like. So first one, red, green, red, green. So we can ask the child as to what comes next. So the child will have to put the red one over here. So this is ABAB pattern. So likewise we can create as many patterns. So something like ABC. Again AB. Again we can put C. You can ask the child what comes next. So the child will see A, B, C, A, B, C. So obviously next is A that has to come in. So this can be done using the cubes. Also there are few printables that are available online. So this is one such printable. So this is again A, B, A, B, A, B pattern. Again the child has to see what comes next. So again it has to put the blue square over here. Likewise again A, 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 B, A, A again blue square. So again the child will have to put the blue square over here. Again A, B, C, A, B, C. So again what has to come next? A red cube has to come next. So such patterns can be created or can be downloaded from the net. So this is one such printables I have got from this website. There are a lot of printables available, so one can take from them. So this is one of those activities. Next activity is again, this is a mat. This is the DIY dies which we have done. So what the child has to do is like roll the dies. So yellow color, what color is this? This is yellow color. So the child has to pick one yellow and put it. Again, the child has to roll it. What color is that? Red color. So the child will take red color and place it next. So like this, the child can cover the mat. One of the interesting way to teach colors. Next activity is shadow matching activity. Again, for this we have few printables which I have taken from our website. These are the few printables: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, R, S, T, W, W, X, and there's Y, Z, somewhere else. So these are the patterns that are readily available. So what the child can do using these cubes is just place the cubes onto the shadow. So the child can do it here, or it can do it on the other plain mat. So what is this? This is A. Interesting way to teach alphabets or any patterns for that matter can be done. Shadow matching activity. Next activity which can be done is coding and decoding. Again, this is a DIY activity which I have done. For this, what the child can do is, here I have given A, B, C, D, E, and for each alphabet I have given a certain color code. So the child has to fill in the pattern according to the color which has been given here. So if you see this, so what is this? This is A. A means, what is the code that we have given? Red. So next, E. What is E? E is orange. So orange one. Next, C. What is C? C is green. So we will put green. D is yellow. Again, yellow. A is red. B is blue. C is green. A is orange. Again, A is red. So yeah, so this is the pattern which we have created using the coding and decoding activity. interesting activity. This is just my idea, coding and decoding activity, which can be done using these cubes. And then the next last activity is this one, which I have done for my toddler, because since he's just 23 months, so I thought I could make something interesting for him. So what he has to do is, he needs to just place the cubes as per the color. So green cube, blue cube, red cube. So likewise, the child has to place the same colored cubes onto the mat. So this can be done for toddlers. Again, the same mat can be used for elder kids, and this can be done as a memory game for them. This mat can be used as a memory game. So these are the activities which can be done using these cubes. I hope this video is useful for moms who have been asking for the activities which can be done using these cubes. Thank you so much.